enable.
Hello and welcome to Making It Big Season 8. I'm your host, A.B. Ravi. What separates men from the boys is, in essence, the story of this week's episode. Some 5 decades ago, R.G. Chandramogan started his business odyssey by selling ice creams in and around Chennai. There were already 40,000 people doing a similar business. So to gain acceptance and build a brand, he moved out of Chennai and focused on small towns and villages. The move clicked. Today, Arun Ice Cream has 60% market share in Tamil Nadu. With strong financials, he went in for backward integration and entered the highly competitive milk business. His disruptive strategy saw Arokya Milk gaining dominant position. This was followed by a slew of launches by way of forward integration. Today, Hatsun Agro Product has emerged as the largest private sector dairy company in the country, producing milk and milk products. The way Chandramogan has built his brand and transformed the dairy farmers of South India, I have no hesitation in calling his company the Amul of Tamil Nadu. Take a look at Hatsun Agro Product story. Chandramogan is a real-life example of what separates men from the boys.
His investment of 13,000 rupees some 47 years back has given him a mind-boggling return of 10,000 crore rupees. Meet the Chennai-based billionaire R.G. Chandramogan, who, through sheer hard work and intense focus, built Hatsun Agro Product into India's largest private sector dairy company. That too, single-handedly. Today, Hatsun Agro, through its 16 plants, has a presence in Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Maharashtra, Kerala, and Karnataka. In all these states, it markets products that cater to both cooking and consumption, like milk, curd, ice creams, dairy whitener, skimmed milk powder, ghee, and paneer. All these products, which touch over 1 million homes, are sold under the brand names Arun Ice Creams, Arokya Milk, Hatsun Curd, Hatsun Paneer, Hatsun Ghee, Hatsun Dairy Whitener, and Ibuco Ice Cream Cakes. Since milk and curd are perishable commodities, its sales are restricted to South India and Maharashtra, while ice creams are sold as far as Odisha. In the case of ghee and milk powder, the company has a pan-India presence. Despite tough competition from brands like Mother Dairy, Amul, Heritage, Quality, Nandini and Parag, Hatsun Agro commands a decent market share in every segment it operates in. Its flagship brand, Arun Ice Cream, enjoys a 60% market share in Tamil Nadu and 30% in the entire South India. The company enjoys similar dominance in segments like pouch milk and curd too. Since its inception, Hatsun has focused only on its core business but has moved up the value chain by backward and forward integration. Thus, from ice cream to milk to cattle feed to ice cream parlors to format stores is how it has integrated over the years. This strategy is clearly reflected in its financials and share prices. Thus, between FY 2013 and FY 2017, the company's turnover has doubled from 2,165 crore rupees to 4,200 crore rupees in FY 2017. The net profit during the same period has grown three times from 45 crore rupees to 134 crore rupees. Not surprisingly, the investors have given its stock a thumbs up. Witness this. Hatsun's share price has moved up from 180 rupees in June 2014 to 900 rupees in November 2017. In the process, the market cap too has gone up five times to 13,200 crore rupees effectively making Chandramogan a billionaire as he holds 74.7% stake in the company. His meteoric growth has won him admiration from competitors too.
In earlier days, we used to compete in ice creams. And I recollect that when he came into ice creams, he used to initially market his products in rural areas and he decided to launch it in Madras. He spent very large sums of money on TV as a media, and all of a sudden everybody was talking about Arun ice creams. He also brought in an innovation which was not normally done. We all thought ice cream was an impulse purchase. He recognized that it was a planned purchase at that particular point of time of evolution of the society, and he created exclusive Arun ice cream parlors. We now compete with each other also on the milk business. I have gone and seen the rural infrastructure that he has created. He has single-handedly ensured that the quality of the milk animals in the areas that he operates is improved. He ensures that they are given the right veterinary support, the right fodder, the right cattle feed. He also has created world-class facilities to ensure that the milk is chilled as soon as milked. He runs a business as a visionary. He does not believe in taking shortcuts. He has had scorching pace of growth in the last 15 years. I have seen the growth. I can only say that this is only the beginning. Picture abhi baki hai.
Hatsun's daily turnover now equals the company's cumulative turnover of its first 20 years. And now the company is aiming at the 5,000 crore rupee mark. This is no overnight success story. It was hard won. It started as a tiny venture that evolved over a period from small to medium to big. In Chandramogan's own words, he was born into a middle-class family in 1949 and grew up in Tiruthangal village, which is close to Sivakasi in Tamil Nadu. After his schooling, he did not pursue higher studies as he was smitten by a business bug. Being the only son, he got the full support of his parents, who sold 86 sovereigns or 688 grams of gold and gave him 13,000 rupees. With that money, the 21-year-old Chandramogan rented a 250-square-foot space in Royapuram and entered the ice cream business with three employees. That was 1970. It was a tough business as there were already some 40,000 players selling ice creams. He managed a modest turnover of 1,15,000 rupees in the first year, but the going was tough. By his own admission, the first 11 years were miserable and he made lots of mistakes. But like the epic hero Arjuna, he too remained intensely focused and patient, and that paid him rich dividends. The first turning point was the order he bagged from Hotel Ambi's Cafe for homogenized and pasteurized ice cream. This meant investing in technology, which he gladly did. That stood him in good stead, and soon he was supplying to college parties and ship chandlers. In this segment, he captured 95% of the market. Even though the cash register was ringing, he wisely decided to move out of Chennai because of the presence of strong brands like Dasa Prakash, Joy and Quality. This strategy of focusing on smaller towns and cities helped Chandramogan gain acceptance and build his brand. Soon, he launched Arun ice cream parlors across Tamil Nadu, and this was followed by Ibico. In 1995, he decided to move up the value chain by getting into the milk business. Tamil Nadu had a strong cooperative brand, Arvin Milk, a toned milk with 3% fat content. To disrupt the market, Chandramogan launched Arokya cow milk with 4.5% fat content and priced it a rupee higher than Arvin. His stakeholders were skeptical. So, to convince them, he flew in the renowned brand consultant Al Rees into Chennai. Rees endorsed Chandramogan's strategy, and that proved to be a game changer. After that, there was no looking back. Today, the company, through its 10,000 Hatsun Milk Bank, procures and processes over 3 million litres of milk daily from nearly 4 million farmers located in 13,000 villages. This number is expected to touch 4 million litres per day by 2020. Besides, the company also produces 500 tons of cattle feed per day, which is sold under the brand name Santosa. What made it possible for a first-generation entrepreneur with not-so-deep pockets to carve out a niche? It was a combination of disruptive strategy, creating strong entry barriers, chasing growth in smaller towns and villages, and incentivizing dairy farmers.
I'll say mainly, we are doing the transparent testing of the milk. I'll say that is most important because many dairies, they will not test the milk in front of the farmers. So we used to open the center there, and when they are pouring the milk, we'll check the milk in front of them. So they know that they are getting the correct payment for the quality milk. Second thing is timely payment. These two things are the reasons for our growth. Remaining dairy, they are not giving veterinary services to the farmers. They are collecting the milk, they are making payment. That's all. But we are giving other services like feed, veterinary services, everything we are giving.
The company, which is touching our daily lives, is growing at 18 to 20% CAGR. Now plans are afoot to go for a rapid expansion and so as to have a national presence. On that note, we need to take a short break. When we come back, CNBC-TV18's AB Ravi talks to RG Chandramogan of Hatsun Agro Product about his strategy and game plan. Also joining us on the show will be Rajat Verma from HSBC. Stay tuned.
Welcome back. He does not hold a formal degree, but comes across as a highly learned person. I caught up with the 68-year-old R.G. Chandramogan, CMD of Hatsun Agro Product, at his corporate headquarters in Chennai to find out how he manages to outsell his competitors in milk by over 8 times. This is what he has to say. Take a look. Mr. Chandramogan, Rajat, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Thank you.
If you were to go back in time and tell us what made you get into the ice candy business when there are already some 40,000 units at those times, and also, the other thing that comes to my mind is, you are from Sivakashi, why did you not think of getting into firecracker business?
The capital what I had, I didn't have any scope to start one of the activities what was prominent in Sivakashi. 13,000 rupees was enough to start an ice cream factory, not a fireworks or matches. Beggars are not choosers. I had my limitations and I started with candy.
Why ice cream? Why not any other business? It was because of...
I was looking for different options. There is a limited capital resources available. This business shooted it at that time.
So was it a long struggle for you when you got into this business?
I will not say the first year has not been a struggle. I made a lot of mistakes on the first year. I didn't know marketing, but the sales came automatically. I thought I can expand. I expanded. I got into problems. From 70 to 81 was a miserable period for us.
So what was the turning point of your life or business that you felt, I'm going to be in this business for good?
We had an inquiry from a hotel called Ambi's Cafe, but they were asking for an ice cream which is homogenized and pasteurized.
Okay.
Normally, these small candy manufacturers, we didn't have the technology. I decided to plunge into it in spite of me losing money. And then I went for the technology, gradually graduated from there. If you take the ice candy manufacturers of 40,000 people along with me, even today, to my knowledge, I'm the only guy who came out of that 40,000 to the next league.
So what made this possible? That is what I want to ask you. There were competition those days like Dasa Prakash, Joy, Quality. So what is that unique thing you did that you were ahead of the race?
Initially, we couldn't compete with them. there were big markets like the points where they were able to give deep freezers and give ice creams. The hotel establishments, they were again giving deep freezers, giving credit which we couldn't offer. Marriage parties, they wanted a brand. So literally we couldn't push them. But two other markets, small markets, like supplying to the college party orders, supplying to the ships that are leaving from here, we were able to get a small entry. This was only accounting for 5% of the business. There we became 90%. 90% of that 5%.
Okay.
This was a business that was ignored by the people.
Okay.
Then we couldn't penetrate more. Then we looked at markets out of city. We went for small towns and other places other than Chennai, and we established ourselves. Instead of getting a market share from them, we looked at the potential market outside. We were able to create a market, develop a market, and integrate the market. That became our backbone.
Okay, let me get Rajat in. Rajat, you are meeting entrepreneurs after entrepreneurs. So when you look at the story Mr. Chandramogan is saying, what is that singularly appeals to or strikes to you?
When I first met Mr. Chandramogan, this was a few years back. So like when I usually meet entrepreneurs, they give a very high-level view of the industry and their company, and sometimes I'm able to get the story out of them as well.
True, yeah.
Which all happened in this meeting, which was on expected lines. But then what happened was that he actually took out his iPad and he took me through some of the sheets which come in as MIS to him on a daily basis, and he could actually drill down to the collection at various points and the sales at various points in various cities. And we spent a lot of time in that meeting just talking about that aspect.
Okay.
Biggest memory that I have of that meeting was that how hands-on he was on that business. So it was not just about, I guess, brand, not just about collecting the milk and setting the pieces in order, but about running it efficiently as well. Expansion of your business, would it be fair to say that it's critical that the collection also expands in that market? Otherwise, it's difficult.
Collection is the most critical part of it. Most critical part of it. Now we collect milk in Maharashtra. We collect about 1.25 lakh liter. Before even getting into the market, we would like to collect and then get into the market.
What is the story behind your brand names? And you don't have an umbrella brand.
We deliberately don't have an umbrella brand. Arun, Arogya, Ibaco, or Hatsun. In its respective segment, in the respective territory, we are the market leaders. The reason is we are a specialist in that particular category. And brand name, one umbrella brand name, is also a strength and also a weakness. Brand consultant like All Rise is preaching that probably you should not take brand from one to another and you get confused. In my opinion, what he says is right.
What are the mantras you applied in your business?
We were willing to differentiate from the competition state.
Okay, that is one, yeah.
And we were also willing to look at opportunities which were not seen by our competitors, like going to the rural markets, which nobody even looked at. Product differentiation and market penetration, we were able to see the new markets. These two things mainly helped us to get into the first penetration. Later, once when we introduced milk itself, instead of city, we were there in every small town possible. This is with the experience of milk, we were able to place the milk.
So what is important to succeed in a business? Ideas or money?
Earlier, I was crapped of money. I thought money is the ultimate thing.
Okay.
Later, once when the success came, I can understand ideas have played a better role. Say, for example, the 4.5% fat was an idea. If I would have taken 3% fat, I would have not gone anywhere. So ideas have played a role. Like, for example, probably the ice cream looking at outstation market was an idea. 4.5% fat, milk is an idea. Later also, whatever we did, I believe that idea is more important to money. And those days, there was no PE money. Now, if you have idea, everybody is willing to put money.
Yeah. So if a youngster came to you for advice, he wants to start a business today, what are the advice you would give him in terms of do's and don'ts?
You should have your own belief in what you think is right. Okay. There is going to be questions. Once when you go off the way, you will have doubts of your own mind. And people around will just criticize saying that what you are doing is not right. In my opinion, these type of destructive criticism, you should be willing to take it in one ear and leave it on the other. And if you can do that, and if you have belief in yourself, there may be some modalities that requires to be changed. endurance, initiating change, and waiting patience. If you have it, you are going to be successful.
So very well put, Mr. Chandramogan. Thanks a lot for being on the show. Thanks, Rajat, for being on the show. Thank you very much. Well, that is Chandramogan talking with conviction about his business odyssey and strategy. These are the mantras he implemented to build Hatsun Agro Products. Have faith in your ideas. Ideas play a bigger role than money. Focus on organic growth. Ability to change and initiate change is a must. Luck comes to people who are tireless. Well, Chandramogan's homespun strategy has worked wonders for him. Before I go, here's an interesting observation made by Warren Buffett, and I quote him. I don't want an easy business for competitors. I want a business with a moat around it. I want a very valuable castle in the middle, and I want the Duke who's in charge of that castle to be very honest and hardworking and able. Then I want a moat around that castle. The moat can be various things. The moat around our auto insurance business is low cost, unquote. The moat around Hatsun business is an efficient milk procurement network and 4 million loyal farmers. On that note, it is time to say goodbye. See you next week with another interesting episode. Till then, keep watching CNBC-TV18.
Focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.